started 2 years ago. At the beginning, we only had students from our Master of International Communications program. Last year and today, we have colleagues from the academia, from our university. We have a guest here. Kathy is our guest.
Kathy. And Elisa from Gallaudet University.
So you're welcome. And we actually have people participating from 8 countries in those 2 sessions, starting, of course, with Bulgaria. And then we have United States, Greece, Italy, Latvia, Nigeria, Syria, and France. So we're a small number of people, but very dedicated to what we do, and it's quite diverse. We have 11 people speaking today, so it's going to be a little bit tense. I would be really grateful if we all, as I'm a speaker, do keep an eye on the clock, let's say, or the watch. I don't know.
How much time do we have each of us? 10 minutes?
Approximately 10 minutes, yes. So we can have some space for discussion. And I would like to present to you the first speaker today, which is my favorite teacher when I was a student, which is nowadays Professor Bushnakova, but known as our favorite Desi. Desi, the floor is yours. The topic is transmedia and communication.
Okay, as I joke, 10 minutes means that you have only 10 times opportunity to make stupid things and broadcast them on Facebook. As those who were in the first session remember, smart people are able to talk short and precisely. I'm not sure that I will be able to do that, but I have my clock. So when 10 minutes are nearly to reach, I will say thank you and I will finish not to eat the time of the other speakers. So, first of all, I want to say that I'm in the English language session, although that I'm from Bulgaria, because I need a challenge. I participate in 19 summer work schools at New Bulgarian University, and I needed a little new challenge to put myself in the shoes and be more prepared for the presentation of today. And as people who know me know that I'm addicted to the power of communication, especially the storytelling, but the transformation of storytelling goes through media to media to media, through social media, virtual reality, augmented reality. And I decided today to talk about a thing that inspired me a lot, the transmedia storytelling and how we can use it in communication. So when I was asked to give a topic for your talk for the summer workshop, yes, of course, I will be talking about transmedia storytelling. And in one moment, I find out that although all transformation go through, the way we prepare ourselves for a talk on a conference is not the same like in the past. In the past, it was what you have in your mind, the research that you have done, and you start writing down the paper. Now, the first thing that you have to do is to ask Google what other people have told about your topic, what kind of video talks you can listen, what kind of scientific papers from all over the world you can see. And at the end, you end with a big mess, because everything you think that is unique have been said by somebody somewhere. And you have to say something new because you think that you are smart. And you have to do it in a transmedia way, because the linear way of communication is not so efficiently today. The first good sign was that when I asked Google about transmedia storytelling, I find out that I have a hot topic. Mm-hmm. If the top 3 results on Google says that transmedia storytelling is the future of communication, I have a good topic. The second, they say that transmedia storytelling is a very important important strategic need in communication. And the third, the future of the normal storytelling is transmedia storytelling. So I was, yes, I got up to the point as to what to say in the 10 minutes that I have. So, because I am good student, or I was good student, I start with the definition of the term. So what, I will not use the who is Alice, but you know what is the word between Alice and who. So what is transmedia? And we know that we have cross media, we have traditional media, we have digital media, and now we have another term. Transmedia is something that uses the unique characteristic of each media and adapt each story to the media without changing the content, but changing the format and maybe adding some of the unique quality of that media. For example, in the last few years, National Geographic used Snapchat to promote a campaign for the animal kinds that will be disappear on the planet. Why? Because, as you know, in Snapchat, messages disappear very quickly. So they use the unique thing of the media to say a story about what they want to fight for. In most of the cases, we have a multimedia platforms, and if you think about what is transmedia, think about Star Wars. You have the movie, you have the Lego games, you have the comic books, you have the all merchandising, and everything make a new story or add something to the traditional story of Star Wars. And because I am at the university, I was looking for who coined the term transmedia storytelling. It's not so obvious, but most of the sources credit Henry Jenkins for using for the first time the transmedia storytelling in the way that I accept the definition of the term. I have the privilege to test how the online education is working, going through a transmedia course in Coursera, which was led in most of the cases by Henry Jenkins. So this is a very important book because it starts thinking about how to use the new media, not to duplicate the content that we have from the traditional media, but to keep the message and make it more suitable for the new media. Looking at the age of the audience, I think that you don't remember how the first TV ad looked in the Bulgarian broadcasting history, but it was a picture and voiceover, which was not how we have to use a new medium, because TV is not another place to put a picture. You need a moving picture, you need people who are talking, and not only one picture static with the voiceover. So when we don't use the specification of the different media, in most of the case we put the content from one media to another, like the first TV commercial in the Bulgarian broadcast. So, transmedia storytelling, and I will read the definition, represent a process where integral elements of a fiction get dispersed systematically across multiple delivery channels for the purpose of creating a unified and coordinated entertainment experience. Entertainment is a very key term in that definition because nowadays we are not used to be very serious. We need infotainment, we need edutainment, and if we are not entertained, we are not eager to take the content that you are willing to spread it. Even politics is a little bit big, very entertainment because we don't. And we have at least one president that is very entertaining. In that moment, I come back again to one of the key theories when I was a student, Marshall McLuhan theory about the medium is the message. And I find out that in this new digital times, this thought have a completely new meaning. If you want to share the same content on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, let's say, you cannot do it in the same way. Because Instagram is a completely different universe. Facebook is a total mess for me because everybody's there. And Twitter have a completely different rules. If you want to move your message from medium to medium, you have to change the format, otherwise we are like the first TV commercial on in Bulgaria. So at the same time, we talk even in the first session today that audiences now don't want to listen. They don't want to be part of your story. They want to be able to create the story together. They want to be a very big part of your story. They want to participate. And at the moment you stop thinking about your customers as a passive receiver of your messages, you start doing transmedia. And of course, we have new technology that help us doing a lot of things. If you ever go for a Pokemon, you know where I mean. People have a different and difficult position and risk situation to catch the Pokemon. In that moment, we don't just seek content. We want to find online the best content. So a lot of people can have the same idea or share the same story, but we have opportunity to compare and to look for the most entertainment, telling the best way or the most watchable video, etc. And we go to the topic of my last, and I hope really last book, because for my life I write three, it's enough. I have now to start reading other people's books. But crowdsourcing is not just a new term. It's something that shows that company, in all the aspects of their work, have to trust more on collaboration with users. That means that they will give some kind of power to the users to operate with their mark. You can say, okay, I will not give anybody power about talking about my brand, but they are doing that because every single student of New Bulgarian University, which mark on their profile on social media that study here, that they study here, with everything that they are doing, they contribute to the image and reputation of New Bulgarian University. I, as a professor here, whatever I'm doing, good or bad, people say, oh, that's what the professors at New Bulgarian University are doing. So I generate content on behalf of the company I work for. It will be better if we work together, the company and me, to create the better content in different platforms. And of course, is it possible to make these transmedia stories keeping the same content? Of course, we can do it. Can we use the power of consumers and their desire to participate? Yes, Ice Bucket Challenge is just on the top to show you what can be achieved if people like your idea. And one of the things that I'm very agree with Henry Jenkins is that he declined to use the term viral and he want to replace it with spreadable. Mm-hmm. credible is something that I like much more than viral. Because spreadable means that there is something good that people want to spread out with an article. And that's why one of my favorite campaigns with user-generated content and transmedia, it's the Museum of Cheetos, where the company asks people what they see in the Cheetos they eat, make a picture, tell a story, and after that they make an offline exhibition on the Central Station in New York on 48th Street and 7th Avenue. Even Coca-Cola, everybody who knows me that knows that I am not able to give any single presentation without speaking about Coca-Cola, so this is the end. But even Coca-Cola asks people how you finish our app. And for those of you who have read the Gianni Rodari Tale by Phone, I don't know how to translate the title in English, maybe you remember that, at least for me, that was the first time in my life where the author gave me a choice. Because every tale at the end has three ends. First, second, and third. And you have the choice to choose the end of the tale that you like most. So, for the end, don't be afraid if young people and kids play a lot of games. That's the toys of 21st century. And I think that you've read it, but information is something that is everywhere. We wear it in our pockets every single minute when we are awake. Or if you are like Professor Orlin Todorov, maybe even during your sleep you get some piece of information in the form of audiobooks. But in hunting society, children play with bows and arrows. In information society, children play with information. And we have to be aware of that fact and give the best tools for children to play with the information and create content for our university, our city, and for ourselves. Thank you.